यस मैम।
देयर यू आर सपोज टू ड्रॉ द लाइन, देन यू हैव टू मेक द अरेंजमेंट कॉलम्स एवरीथिंग. टेक एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस फॉर कॉलेज इटसेल्फ. इन द कॉलेज इन द रजिस्टर बुक वी वर यूज्ड टू क्रिएट अ लाइन, रोल नंबर, सीरियल नंबर, then what name, address, then which college you have come, your 10 standard marks, then 12 standard marks, everything it was written in a paper based. Now assume that 10,000 or 1,000 students are there, how long you are going to take to write that all the information, right? So now it is very difficult to maintain the data with the help of paper based. So, but it was getting stored, somehow it was used to get the stored here. But if you see the today's generation, we are completely using this what automated database. Automated database means what? Once you have entered the data, it can be stored for n number of years. I'm not saying only for the 10 years. It can be stored for 20 years, for 50 years, but it should be maintained. Getting? So here in this database management system, which is a very most important subject for you people, it is not only for the fourth semester you have learned and you should leave it. No. This database management system you are supposed to carry with you till you do work, or I can say it as a sixth semester if you start working on the project. Not only the sixth semester project, or you can start normal project also here once extra courses will be added here. Now also, basic example, few days back, this voting system was there here, right? So voting system was there. You were used to check whether you are eligible to vote or no. Of course, you are eligible above 18 till there. But you will check where your data, where your name is being enrolled, which booth it was enrolled, where you are supposed to go to vote, right? For that purpose, normally we open this what website or application form, where our name it is there, are we registered or no, for vaccination also here. So we are supposed to check. So those data, it is getting stored somewhere in the database, somewhere in the database. Now the question arises somewhere. What is this somewhere? This somewhere, it is what your data is being stored here. How your data is being stored? I can say that Shruti, S-H-R-U-T-I, n number of Shrutis are there. How you are going to recognize me as a Shruti Kulkarni only, right? How it is possible? So many Shrutis are there. So for that purpose, most of the things are getting stored in the specific way or the format, I can say that I can be recognized as a Shruti Kulkarni with the help of my voter ID or my Aadhaar card ID. How it is done? So that is getting stored in the database, somewhere in the database, somewhere still that somewhere has to come here. Getting? So that somewhere you are supposed to learn in this database management system. Okay. Now that database management system, before beginning with the database management system, you are supposed to remember the word called as curd. You say in Marathi, what? Dahi, normal, dahi, yeah. Mosaru, we will say. So curd, it is a, actually we will say it as a crude, but normally I say it as a what? Curd, C-U-R-D. Here the curd represents for the database management system. C is representing as a create. Then U is representing as a update. Then R is representing as a retrieve, and D it is representing, it is what, delete. Okay. So curd, you are supposed to remember every time in the database management system. I think some of the students are living in between my classes. Don't get bored. As today it is the introduction, I have to begin with what exactly the database management system, where you are supposed to use, and basic concepts I'm going to clear here. Okay. So don't leave the class here. So curled, I was curled. Anyway. So C represents the create, U represents the update, and R represents the retrieve, and the D represents this word delete here. So these four specific words you are supposed to carry with your TBMS here. And along with your practical also, as this database management system is not only of theory subject, you are going to work on this word practical also. As we are using this word curled, create. Create means what? You have to create a database. U means what? Update the database. Sometimes this what? Mobile number will be changed, or your surname or your initial, anything can be changed here. For that purpose, updation should be there here. Retrieve, the word retrieve you have to keep in your mind always. Once your database practical or session will start here, the queries means what, questions, okay? Queries will be starting as a specifying that retrieve the roll number those who have scored above 90%. I want a student those who have scored above 90 in the DBMS subject. What you people will do, you will open that marks, this what list, you will go on searching. Roll number one, so and so. Roll number two, then you will note it down. You will go on scrolling. Assume that you people are having the data of 1,000 students and you are searching the students those who have scored above 90 marks. It is very difficult. It is a long time consuming process. How much time you are going to take that who have scored above 90 in the DBMS subject? Very hard to find out. Okay, you will find out manually somehow, somewhere management it is there. But if you are having a kind of a database management system software, or you know the query, or you know the working of database management system, why can't you apply this logic? So that time you already, the database will be there with the people where in the code create is there. Okay. From that database, just you are supposed to write this query. Query is also there. I'll be telling you all these things. Select star from where? Just now I've repeated. Select star from where? The question might be thinking for you people. What Pam is telling, select star from where? This select star from where you have to use in your practical session continuously for the query purpose. So retrieve. Come back to the point called as a retrieve. As I have said that I want the students, those who have scored above 90 in the DBMS year. How are you going to retrieve? Instead of searching manually, this what Maitri has scored 90, Sai Prakash has scored above 90, Aishwarya has scored, how long Renuka has scored, too many things are there. If you write a query immediately, select star from so and fourth semester where marks are greater than 90. If you write this immediately, all the students' name will come who have scored above 90. Without any manual work, without any finding who has scored above 90. Nah. Just you have to write the query, immediately the result will come and that retrieve word will be there here. In all your queries, the question will arise as a retrieve those who have scored above 90 in the DBMS. Retrieve the students, those who stay in Belgaum. Retrieve the students, those who are above 45. These all things you have to work. Then D. D represent this word delete. Delete means what? In your file-based system, to delete the name, what we were used to do? We were used to prepare another register book or another notebook. Delete or eraser we were used to take. Is that possible for 10,000 records? No, it is not possible. It is very difficult here. If you say delete option from the respective table or from the respective database, automatically it will get deleted here. So these are the four words which is called as a curled, or you can say as a crude, C-U-R-D here. Create, retrieve, update, delete, or you can say it as a curl also. Getting? So let us begin with the database management system subject. So for your first unit synopsis means what you are going to learn in your first unit, database management system. Make sure before starting with the unit one, make sure yourself that you are not supposed to miss any of the classes. Why? The reason to not to miss the classes, it is that I'm going to take the practical session along with the theory subject also here. Getting? After your first unit, immediately I have to start with the practical session so that you can practice yourself. In this unit, you will have to learn the synopsis, which is called as a database and database users. In this, you will learn what is data, what is a database. Then come to the main point, actually the definition of the database management system, database users. In the database users, this database users are getting categorized as actors on the scene and workers behind the scene. If they ask you the question in the examination, who are the database users, please don't get confused between the actors on the scene and workers behind the scene. I will be telling you this again when this topic comes here. So database users is similar as actors on the scene and workers behind the scene. Okay. Then every year regular question specifies that explain the characteristics of database approach DBMS or give the characteristics of DBMS. They may ask you the question as a characteristics of database approach. Please don't get confused between the characteristics of DBMS or characteristics of database approach. This is completely similar. No difference here. Then the actors on the scene. Don't think that actors like a film or Bollywood. No. Actors on the scene means what? Who are the users? Who are going to work on the database? Who are those users? Then workers behind the scene. Getting backside of the database, who are there here? Now, I can tell you the basic thing here. Who are the actors on the scene and workers behind the scene? Workers behind the scene means what now? Normally, when you have started registering for the vaccination of the COVID, right? So, you will register yourself. So, after registering that data, it is getting stored in the database. Fine? And where it will get stored in the database? Somewhere it will get stored in the database. And those people are there. They will decide when your vaccination will be there. Getting so when your vaccination will be there, so they will decide. So who are those workers behind the scene? Getting, and you people are the actors on the scene. You are retrieving the data. You yourself are registering the data. You yourself are checking when is your vaccination, first dose, when is the second dose. So this is what the actors on the scene. Live example I can tell. Then advantages of using the DBMS. Why you have to use the database management system? Comparison between the file-based database system and the today's generation database management system. And the brief history that I can tell you very easily. So let us begin with a few small topics today. What is the database and database users? Yes. Now, can anyone tell me what is data? Actually, first of all, tell me what is the data here. Anyone? What is the data? Sai Prakash?
Collection of information.
Or Renuka? Anyone?
Collection of information.
Yes?
Collection of information and the details.
Nobody?
Known facts that can be recorded and have an implicit meaning.
Okay. No worries. I'll check what is the data here. Can be in information where the information can be stored in any format. Now, normal. In your college also. In our college, Prashant sir will be storing all the data here. Right? Now I'll tell you the basic example. I have told you that you have taken the admission. Once the admission process is done, all the information will be stored. You will get a roll number, your name, everything will be stored. So that is also one kind of a data. Right? Our staff information which is there, that is also data here. Now I'm handling the subject which is called as a database management system. So DBMS, it is getting stored in the timetable. That is one data here. So actually the data is what, it is a term similar recordable facts where the recording is there here. I mean, not this recording, recordable facts, observation. Observation means what, who has, normal way, who will be, now live example I can tell. Observation for me, the data, it is what some participants, some students are missing the class. Some are attending the class, some are going, as it was 63, 64, then I'm observing. Who are their students? So that is also one kind of a data for me here, right? Then factual information. Factual information means what? The condition. You have to score so and so marks. You should be eligible to take the vaccination. That is also one kind of a data. Above 18 years, which is being started from the 1st May. So you have a 1st May, it is one data. That is a date. And above for this what 18 years, that is also one data here. Getting, then set of values that can be processed with the help of computer system and the DBMS software. That is what the data here. Example, we can say, now I will say that Sai Prakash, you have to store all the information of today's class. I will say him or Maitri, I will tell that, Maitri, you have to store the information about those who have attended my class today. So what your people will do, you will write today is the 10th May 2021, DBM Mesh, Shruti ma'am's class. You will say, who all have attended? You will go on inserting the roll number or the name. What is that? That is the date of today's my class. Getting. So you will write the roll number, you will specify the date. So that is one kind of a data. Come to the main part. What is the database now? Here, the database is a collection of data elements, any kind of a data, factual information, observation, set of values. This is what the data here, or the recordable facts also. Database is a collection of a data elements or the facts stored in a computer system in a systematic way or in a specific way. Getting now our register attendance sheet, you might have seen how it was. It was a roll number, the name was there, and after that columns was there here. There we are supposed to write today's date here. So after that we were used to go on tick mark 1 2 1 1 1 1, which means it is being present today for me. So that is what the, in the systematic way here. Database, it is a collection of data elements or facts stored in a computer system in a systematic way. Okay. Then define the DBMS. If you are seeing this DBMS definition, this is not complete definition of the DBMS. It is about to come in the next slide. So please don't get confused between this DBMS definition, what I'm going to explain now, and which is there for the next slide. And I will be telling you which is the proper definition of the database management system software here. So have a look over here. First of all, DBMS, the computer program, actually, whatever, if you are processing the word process, now I'm showing this what PPT, it is a one kind of a program PPT. So the computer program used to manage and query a database is known as database management system program. You have written the C program, right? You have done the Java program. Yes, it is being written in a specific way and the output is coming. Normal Java program was there here. You have created the data. I don't know where, whether you have created the database or not. That is the side part, but in your this what structure program or stack program, so there the structure will be there, linked list will be there here, insert the elements, array, some specific format is there here. So computer program used to manage and query a database known as database management system. Manage matlab kya, you are supposed to create a database. After creating the database, you are supposed to insert the data here. Getting. Now, normally in your this what college also, you have done your third semester, right? Now you are going to jump for the fourth semester. So what happens? Third semester roll number you had, right now third semester only you are supposed to use. Fourth semester, what is going to get updated? Roll name, at least that will be there here. Only this what roll number will be updated here. So that is what the query database. If we ask for the Prashant sir, normal way, Prashant sir, I want the this what attendance of the student, those whose attendance is less than 65%. He will not go on checking separate. He will open the database of your fourth semester system student, and our class records will be there. Like I have taken 45 classes. Example, 45 classes I have taken. In that 45 classes, who all have attended this what above 60% and below 60%. He will open that data, automatically the attendance result will come. What is being done? It is being programmed, it is being managed, it is being queried. You are not supposed to find out the manually. You have to give a query. Just before a few minutes back, I have told that I want the students who have scored above 90 marks in the subject TBMS. He will not go on finding the individual, finding manually. Just you are supposed to write the query here. So it is being done with the help of database management system software. Okay. So this is done. Then, so a database is a collection of related data that we can use for defining, constructing, and manipulating here. So these are the three things of your database management system, DCM here. I can say it as a DCM. Defining Now, if I say for Sai Prakash, I want the students to have scored above 90 in your Java subject. How he is going to find out? He will tell me, ma'am, give me 1 hour, I'll find out here. But why 1 hour you need? Where the work will happen within 1 minute, right? If your database is there here. So here, for that purpose, in your database management system, before beginning with the practical session or before beginning with the actually database management system, you are supposed to learn these three concepts. Very easiest it is there. Defining, constructing, manipulating here. Where it is being used. Now your class, it is there here. Your third semester results are about to occur. Don't know when it is going to happen. And let us see. Let us keep aside here. Let us see about the first semester and the second semester. Already that data is there here. Who has created that data? The creation of the database is being done by the Prashant sir here. Okay. So that is one, defining a database. He has created a structure. He has created a column which is called as a roll number. He has created a name column where your name will be stored. Then he has created this what 7 columns where the subjects are there here. This what subject 1, subject 2, subject 3. The structure has been created. Hitting. So that is what defining the database. Now I'm telling you basic way. Actually, the definition will come in your database management system. That's way. Okay. So definition is done. Construction is there. Construction means what? He has to go on inserting the data. Sai Prakash, Maitri, then Renuka, Aishwarya, Saurabh, Yash, everything they have to provide here. Construction is done. Sai Prakash, roll number is so and so. Subject 1, 95. Subject 2, 98. Everything he has got constructed. Ho gaya? Then what is manipulating here? Manipulation means what? Updation. Suppose by mistake I have inserted the Sai Prakash marks as 64, where we have to insert this what 95. Manipulation, what is happening? I'm not going to recreate the Sai Prakash data, all information again. What I do, I just only update the marks where he has got 64, that is being replaced by 95. A manipulation is there. So these are the three things you have to learn. That is a defining a database, construction of the database, manipulation of the data. Sufficient. Okay. Then now you have a look over here and think what the database is there. What is actually the database? It is a collection of the data elements or data facts. So here see raw data. Anyhow information, admission time. Anyhow, the information has come here. So this is the raw data here. Figures means what? Figures will come as a marks and all. Statistics means what? It will come as a percentage. Anything values means what? Any values. Facts means what? Based on the fact. Condition like this way. So here with the help of database management system, this is the database. Okay. This is the database management system. With this DBMS, what all things you can do? You can store the data. You can retrieve the data. You can administration. This also will come in your, this what workers behind the scene or actors on the scene. Then you can provide the reports. You can generate the reports from your first semester to the sixth semester. You can use the queries. Find out the queries. Instead of going manually, you have to write the queries. Select star from so and so. You can secure the data in your DBMS software. Then these all things has become as a backside. So here, front end should be there, no, for accessing the application. Now, right now, your right example, if you are registering for the vaccination above 18 years, we are just inserting the data. We are writing the name. Do we know that how that name backside data is there? Do we know that how that data is going to get stored? Do we know that where it will come go our data? Do we know that once we provide the mobile number, we will get the OTP? Are we aware from where the OTP is coming? No, we are just here. We are here. Example here, it is what? We are registering for the vaccination above 18 years. We don't know how our data is getting stored. I just write Shruti Kulkarni. Then I'll provide this what female. I'll provide this what age. Getting everything I can provide here. My first vaccination, so and so. We are just inserting the data. But backside, where it is getting? So this, all the data is getting stored over here. And here we are the people where we are using the software application based on the business logic here. Aadhaar card updation, application front end is different. Your vaccination application is different here. So that is what the front end, this is being used by the TBMS here, and where raw data is also there. Getting? So this is what actually the database management system here. Your Facebook account also data. N number of accounts are getting created. No matter whether it is a fake or whether it is a true one, but it is getting created somewhere, it is getting stored here. So that is also one kind of a database here. Now come to the main point, actually, what is database management system or define database management system? You yourself have a look for the slide and let me know. For 10 seconds, have a look. Yes, a database management system. Please don't get confusion between the what is a database and what is a DBMS. A database management system is a one software. Okay. We people are going to work of creation of the database, then queries here. Assume that we have prepared the application and we are going to sell that application outside. You take an example of this word vaccination itself or Aadhaar card application. When we are entering that data, it is a software for us. But at the backside, who has created? The government has created. How they had created, what work they are applying, what constraints they are applying, what method they are applying, that we have to learn in this our database management system. Very, very, very easiest is there. If you learn, if you completely be aware of how the data is done, easily you can start working on your project of your sixth semester. No matter what kind of a language you're going to take, either Java or Python or PHP or Android also. Getting? If you learn this, all the queries now itself, those queries can be applied anywhere in the higher level studies when your project, you're going to develop that here. Okay. So let us see. It is a software package to facilitate the creation and the maintenance of a computerized database. It is a one kind of a software package. It will help us to create a database and maintain the database here. Getting? For the vaccination purpose, database has been created automatically here. It has been created. Only what we are doing, we are inserting our information here. It is getting stored in the vaccination database here. Getting? If you want to update everything, now suppose my vaccination was on so and so, I didn't go. What I have to do, I have to contact to that again, one more date will be there. That is getting stored in the database. Maintenance is done here. So it is this what? It is a software package to facilitate the creation and maintenance of the computerized database. Their maintenance, it can be of 10 years, 20 years, 25 years, no matter here. A database system is a DBMS together with the data itself. They may ask you the question, what is database system also? It is a DBMS together with the data itself here. Okay, database system. Only data is getting stored. Database management system software, it is what? The data is already present. You can create the database. You can update the database. You can retrieve the database. And you can delete the database here. Database system is what? Sirf data hai usme. Kuch karne ko nahi aata. That is what the database system. But database management system, it is what? You can create, you can maintain, you can update, you can delete, or you can retrieve. So just remember, it is a software package to facilitate the creation and the maintenance of the database. Or you can say it as a, it is a collection of program that enables the user to create and maintain a database here. Or it is a common purpose software system which is used for the creation, which is used for constructing, for defining, for manipulating, and for sharing the database among the various users and applications. Just now I have said that it can be used to share the database among the users and applications also here. Now your vaccination database itself, it is not only taking the information, those who are eligible only above 18 years, no. Already 45 years also database is there. About 60 also it is there. First dose also there. Second dose also there. It is not only for the first dose. everything it is there getting, so it can be shared among others also. So what is the database management system? Software package to create and maintain the computerized database here. Next, who are the database users? I'll still repeat. Database users and actors on the scene and workers behind the scene are same. Any person who uses the database and takes the benefits from the database is considered as a database user. Now our college staff, they are the database users here. They will access the database. We staff also, we can access the database from the database here. It is what considered as a database users. Actually, what? Who are the database users? They can be programmers. If you are going to create a project, now your sixth semester, your seniors, they have started creating the project. So there, who are those here? Those are the programmers, right? Because they are constructing the project. This what design also, and they are managing the database also. So those are the programmers, engineers. Once you visit the companies, once you join the companies, you are the engineers here. Scientists are the database users. Business person, if we go to any of the grocery store or any of the DMart here store, who are willing that this what our products, whatever we have purchased, those are also the database users. Or can be an employee also here. Getting your employee, can be an employee to access the customer information here. Getting. Then different database user, actually it is being categorized in two parts. One, it is a actors on the scene, and the second one, it is what workers behind the scene. So these are the two main members of your database users. They will ask you the question. They will not ask directly who are the database users. Basically, they will ask the question as a actors on the scene and workers behind the scene. Getting? So these actors on the scene and workers behind the scene, which is being covered separately here. So let us have a look last slide. Simplified database system environment. Actually, how your database management system software is being created. So here you people are there here. I mean, we all, users, programmers, we are going to access. Now your vaccination, it is there. Then your application programs or queries. What is this application program? One, this what format is there. There we are supposed to insert our information. Name, age, then date of birth, anything. What document we are going to attach, whether Aadhaar card or voter ID. So these will come application programs or queries. Then this is a database system. Then here it is what database management system software here. So what it is this here? Here it is a software to process queries or programs. Here software to access the stored data. Already the data is available. How we are going to access, that is being done by the TBMS software. Then once we insert our information, our vaccination process, it will be stored over here. It will start querying from here where it has to access the stored data. So where it will get stored? Stored database here. And here it is what stored database. Two things are there. Please don't get confused here. This is the format. This is the structure. And here it is what actually data will be stored here. Here I can say this is what roll number, name, percentage. Only I am saying roll number, name, percentage. Here what will happen? Roll number, name, percentage. Roll number 1, Sai Prakash, 95. Roll number 2, Maitri, 92. Okay. Then roll number 3, Renuka. Then percentage what? 85. Here it is there. Here it is what? Metadata only. Roll number, name, anything. So two things are there here. Getting? Not much you will understand, but I'll resume the class tomorrow here, whenever my next class is there. Till then, start giving the attendance for me. If you don't know the roll number of your fourth semester, please give the roll number of your third semester itself here. If you have given the roll number, you can leave my class. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.